Jason, the wind hasn't been much of a factor this morning, has it? At least
not
locally?
In the metro.
Okay.
Not in the metro. The other side of the central mountain chain, though, that wind is whipping 30 miles per hour. And boy, does it ever make a difference out there. You can see the actual temperature right now has fallen to 19 in Santa Fe. So that cooler air, or colder air, nothing cool about this, colder air is starting to spread into that area. And look at that temperature changing in Los Alamos right now, 19 degrees there. But real story is just the bitter cold air. And the core of this cold air, you can see, as I expand the view, still way up here to the north. Minus 14 in Casper, minus 12 in Denver. These aren't the wind chills. That's the actual temperature. Mind you, 7 in Pueblo. So you can see there's still more cold air to come. We're just kind of getting started on this. So a frigid forecast, no doubt about it. What happened with that cold front, though, is it kind of got locked up against the central mountain chain. This initial surge of cold air is pretty shallow, and it has a hard time getting over physical barriers like mountains. That's why you see most of this cold air out over the plains and back into the plains of Colorado and back into New Mexico here. But some of this cold air, especially as the cold air mass begins to deepen a little later today and tonight, will spread on off towards the west. So western areas will start to feel the effects of this. And of course, as we look back towards the east and central sections even, there could be a few stray snow flurries kind of coming in. Here's your satellite photograph. When it comes to talking about the potential for snow flurries, actually, if you look at what's happening here, even though we've been talking about all this cold air obviously kind of coming in from the north like this, it's these little series of weak disturbances in the upper atmosphere kind of tracking in from the west that could bring a slight chance for a few snow flurries as time goes by. So that's why we're going to keep an eye on that for you during the overnight hours tonight and on into tomorrow. Northwest, how about temperatures in the 30s and 40s today? Looks like 40s and maybe some 50s down towards the southwest. This is about a 10 degree drop from yesterday's readings. That's what we're expecting, 10 to 15 degrees colder in the western areas, and of course 20 to 30 degrees colder in the eastern areas. And in some cases, from the southeast to the northeast, we could see a reduction of as much as 40 degrees from highs yesterday to highs today. That'll be the case up especially in Union County. Now, while we do have clouds passing over, we're not seeing a lot of snow, maybe a little spot snow shower here or there. We could squeeze out a flurry around Santa Fe. But Santa Fe, we saw your 19 now. The cold air is coming in, so you'll park it in the low 30s for the next few days. The East Mountains, the cold air is moving in there also. Temperatures today will only make it up to about the freezing mark, give or take a couple of degrees, and that wind certainly going to blow there. That makes it cold. Winds continuing to be a possibility around here. They haven't picked up yet, but they will once we get into the afternoon, and that colder air is coming in. Not as warm as yesterday, obviously. 42 my high for the day. By the way, I came up with one.
Oh, you did?
Finally did.
Yeah.
Green Bay Packer fans put on shirts.
Oh, that's good. Of course, this is what Jason's talking about.
That's right. He's referring to our question of the day. It's so cold that, and we've had a lot of responses filling in that answer. Kathleen from Carlsbad says it's so cold, North Pole moves south. Ken says cows are giving ice milk. Juan in Tucumcari says even Tiger Woods stayed in his own bed.
Ooh, that's kind of edgy. Oh. Okay, it's so cold that polar bears are sitting in front of my fireplace sporting long underwear and fur coats. That's from Tina Marie. It's so cold UPS drivers are wearing long pants. That's from Diane Cannon. I love that one. And this one is from Tammy. Tammy's gone crazy this morning. She's really going. I don't know if you can air this, but it's so cold the fire hydrant is begging a dog to beep on it. See, I knew I'd find a way to get
you
that
did.
In there.
You did that well. We're going to take some answers up until the end of the show, and then we're going to give away a $50 gift certificate to Santiago's restaurant. So that's certainly worth getting in a few more guesses. In the meantime,